Ferguson, sponsored by Applebee's. Try Applebee's new spirited cuisine menu, skillfully crafted with a touch of whiskey, wine, and beer. See you tomorrow.
Special guest band, our team leader, Richie Sambora. We have a horse that's learning Japanese. Secretariat, everybody. And we've got a gay robot skeleton.
And if you don't find that entertaining, then I suggest you find some other place to be.
It is a great day for America. It's a great day for His Holiness Pope Benedict, who finally joined Twitter today. That's true. He did, that's true. After a week of deliberation, the smoke came out and he decided that... This is his Twitter name, and it's not a joke. The Twitter name of the Pope is Pontifex. I think that's only because Dude in a Big Hat was already taken by Trace Atkins, but... I did a Trace Atkins joke.
I hear you, man. Yeah.
Do you know what's great? That you're such a rock star that even when you're talking normally, it kind of sounds like a stadium.
I just had that built in my head.
That was crazy.
Yeah, it's great. Do you listen to this?
Yeah, do that again, man.
Yeah.
I just had that built into my head.
Wow. Do you know what you should... Richard, could you ask us if we feel all right?
Do you feel all right?
Yeah!
I got that.
All right, I got to get on. You do your, whatever you guys do.
What do we do?
I don't know what you do. I take vitamins, do your lunges. What do you do?
I'm going to go with vitamins, okay.
Yeah. Do you understand any of this?
Yeah, I didn't get a word.
Right, okay. Anyway, over the weekend, President Obama attended the White House Christmas party. Decorations were everywhere, including 54 separate Christmas trees. Historians say that not this... Sorry, everyone, I'm very high right now. Historians say that not this much wood has been in the White House since Bill Clinton was interviewing interns.
Yeah.
I did it, I jumped.
I got you a surprise present. My penis.
Over in Britain, of course, it's a great day today. Prince William and his lovely bride, Kiki Wigglesworth, announced that she is pregnant. That's right. She is. She's got a crumpet in the noggle pot. A doodle in the noodle. What it, Jeff? You got
a scone in the bread box.
Scone in the bread box. What we're saying is the crown jewels are officially functional. That's it. They work. And since these are the royals, there had to be a formal proclamation. They issued it on a parchment. Do we have the parchment? Do we have it? Bridger, thank goodness, is here with the parchment. It's getting so I hardly recognize this show anymore. Now, here's a parchment for the royal family. It says, and I quote, His Royal Highness Prince William, Duke of Cambridge, did indeed get all up in that. Ah, yeah, making babies, booyah, mm-mm. It's no secret William and Kate have been trying for a while. The last 6 months has been a sign outside their house, if the palace is a-rockin', don't come a-knockin'. And they've been married for a year and a half. That's like five marriages for a Kardashian. That's like five. What the hell?
Yeah, man.
Hey, shh. Look, they're talking to each other. They're saying musician things.
The hell are they talking about?
I don't know. I think they were actually talking about the Kardashian joke.
It was top stuff.
Was that joke in G? Was that a G, that? What key was that joke in?
We're talking about the family jewels that you were talking about before.
He's very attractive, isn't he?
Very sexy.
Very. Oh, yeah. You're very attractive. Yeah. Yeah, you see, now, this is the thing. If I could play the guitar... Do you know what it is? It's because women see you go like that with your hand when you're doing the feedback.
Yeah, yeah.
They're like, you could do that to me.
I'll tell you what. I do it all the time.
That's what it, women
that's
are like.
My move. You know, people have a move. I got my move.
Well, that's it. So when you're, like, when you're dating a girl, she has to stand over there so you go like that.
Yeah, she got to be over this way. Hey, Secretariat likes that too, man. Look.
Yeah, no, Secretariat's enjoying himself immensely. Knock it off! Creepy! I'm trying to talk about the royal baby. Anyway, this is bad news for the paparazzi. A nursing baby is going to cover up this woman's breast. Please, not pity. Anything but that. Kate said to be very nervous about giving birth. Giving birth to a baby wearing a crown is, of course, very difficult. That's what happens. That's how you know they're royal. That's where the word crowning comes from. I just made up in my head, but it's true. Apparently, the royal couple told their families over the weekend. Prince William called his father and said he had exciting news, and Charles said, the Queen is dead. We have a photograph of Queen Elizabeth with Prince Charles as a baby. Look at that, isn't that adorable? Look at that, it's lovely, yeah, I know. He's thinking, right there, he's thinking, maybe I can strangle her with the pearls. Are you excited about the royal baby, Jeff? Is that you excited?
That's
or...
my move. That's my move. I was showing you.
That can't be. That's Richie's move. Richie's move is.
Yeah. Jeff's already stole my move.
That's his move.
Hey, stop.
Anyway, you, all right. You want to see my move then?
Yeah,
my move. You can't see what I'm doing with my hands right now, but it's very dirty. Dirty. All right, band, take us into the commercial break, band. Come on, do the thing. You don't want to be too good. It'll put people off. Welcome back. back, everybody. Welcome back to the first of the many shows in which we'll be actually better than we used to be.
Yeah, it's a little scary, man.
Yeah, it's a little. I mean, the show so far. See, right there, I'm trying to bring us back to our usual level of crap.
Yeah, yeah.
Because it's too good.
It's too good.
People are going to be like, "This is too good. I gotta switch off."
like they normally do, right? Yeah,
exactly. I'm frankly concerned. All right, can you do the tweets and the emails jingle?
Yeah, baby.
All right, go do that. At the end, did you see there was a flame at the end?
What the hell, man?
How the hell do you, Richie, come over and do tweets and emails with me tonight?
Yeah. I will, man. Richie Sambora.
Awesome. My brother.
How are you, man?
I'm doing good.
I'm having a good time.
You're doing great. It's a little too good, and also my voice has gone a little bit. Did you hear it?
No, it was awesome.
No. I mean, it was fine then, but now it's gone. And.
Because you're having too much fun. Right?
I'm having too much fun. I feel like it's like I'm not sober anymore.
That's good. It's coming back.
it's a little unnerving. For Jeff, Jeff's a little jealous.
My man.
Hey,
how are you, my friend?
What's going on, man?
How are you, my friend?
You know, I can make flames come out of my ass, so, yeah. Just letting you know.
You guys, find a way, Jeff. Find a way. It's Richie Sambora. You'll be all right.
No,
it's
love Richie. I'd take a hit. I'd go at him. Oh, yeah.
I love you, Jeff, but not in that way.
Yeah,
it's all
we'll
good,
see
though.
About that.
So I'm happy to be here, man. It's all good.
Good. I think you're settling down into the mediocrity now, Richie. That's good. All right, we're doing the tweets and emails. You ready?
Yeah, man.
All right, this is from Marla in Tacoma, Washington. You ever been there?
Tacoma.
No.
He did a thing!
What the hell was that?
That was awesome!
I went into Carson.
It was good.
I went into the great Karnak.
You did? Yeah,
I did.
I mean, he's... Jeff?
Tacoma. Mm.
Yeah.
Oh, wait a minute.
May your next Christmas present consist of an early yak chips.
Yeah, you're really getting the hang of it now, Richie. All right, now.
You don't like that?
No, I thought it was great. That's the thing.
Hey, come on.
No, wait. Don't turn to the audience and say, hey, come on. Don't say that. That's a rock and roll thing. That's like saying, do you feel all right? No, you can't do any of that.
You know what you do? Like what? This. You're not even looking at me. The one that get turned on by that, they don't even know why.
All right, not good.
Especially when you do that high pitched thing.
Ooh. Yeah. All right. That's feedback right there. You should know what that is.
I do.
Feedback. and then. Oh. Hey, you ever hear that sound? Oh.
Yeah. Maybe that even works better.
All right, dear Craig and Jeff, and Richie, it doesn't say that, but I'm adding.
Okay.
All right.
You adding me in?
Yeah, I'm adding you in.
Thank you.
Right, in my head. I'm having trouble getting up when the weather is cold and rainy. Any suggestions? Well, Richie, you're a rock star. They're renowned for getting up early in the morning. How do you do it?
Call room service number one.
Yeah,
you know?
He has no idea what you're talking about.
That's the first thing you gotta do.
You ever been to Tacoma, Washington?
If I did, I don't remember. That means I probably was there.
Hey, wait. Something. Wait, this
no,
is...
No, I'm serious, you know.
What?
There was a portion of my life, as well as yours, that, you know, how much do you really remember at it at one specific period of time?
Well, for me, it's what's weird is I can
Between
remember
was
your
15
life...
Between 15 and 45.
Yeah. No, I can remember your life. I just can't remember my own. This is from Jerry in Altadena in California. Now, this does actually say Craig, GP, and Richie Sambora right there.
Okay,
it actually says it. Yeah, there you go. See?
What does he want?
Well, he says, dear boys, could you please tell me where you guys are all hanging out after the show tonight?
We're going to go watch a game.
You want to go watch the, yeah.
We're going to go watch the football game.
Oh, God, I'm shooting.
Hey, the Giants are playing.
You're not cool enough to hang with us, is what I'm saying. If only that were true.
You and I will go have some near beer, so it'll be all right.
Nah, I can't have near beer. If I have near beer, then it's near tequila and near Coke. That's what it is. That's the way it is for me.
I set you up for the slam dunk. Here you go. Here you go. Yeah.
I just near it. Yeah. All right.
What else we got?
Emily in Ithaca, New York. I've been there.
I've been
there. And I've also been to Ithaca, New York.
You did it before. I was going there. I was going there. You beat me. Yeah.
All right.
It's cold in Ithaca. It really is. It's cold.
It is cold. It's cold in Ithaca. Thanks.
Upstate New York.
After the Richie's done with the weather, we're going to have sports. Jeff Peterson. Jeff, who's your tip for the Super Bowl this year?
Well, lots of sweaty guys in the locker room, Craig. It's getting me all worked up. Back to you.
Okay, so what's up in Ithaca?
I don't want to read it. It was all asking questions and stuff.
That's what they do with us.
Yeah, have you ever seen a turkey?
Of course.
Have you ever seen a turkey like that?
No. Have you?
Yeah.
I never seen them with the feathers on them. I only seen them like...
What, when they're all naked?
Yeah, they're all naked. Yeah. I'm ready to eat them.
When they're naked and you're ready to eat them, is what you said?
It depends on the gender of the turkey.
Dear Craig and Jeff Peterson, if you invite Richie Sambora to go clubbing with you, I bet he'd play Here Come the Players very well. Oh, yeah. When Jeff and I walk into a club, Jeff, what do the ladies say when we walk into a club?
Here come the players!
Yes! Yeah. And then what do they say? Yeah, I don't know if you're cool enough for that, Richie. Finally, this is from Jessie in... doesn't say where she's from. Do you know
Jessie? I like her already.
She's mysterious. Well, it might not be a she. Jessie's one of those names. Could be a guy or a lady. Like Susan, one of those names.
Okay. Yeah? Strike that for the record.
Dear Craig and Jeff and Richie Sambora, who dresses Jeff each night? I think the question, more accurately put, is who undresses Jeff? Jeff, who undresses you at the end of the night?
I think I'm looking right at him.
The horse?
Yeah.
You know, I have to say, this show is even freakier than I thought it was. No,
no. Secretary likes when you do that.
No, it's not that easy to do that when you've got hooves. Take a break. We'll be right back with Seth MacFarlane. You can go. Seth MacFarlane. Tonight is a genuine American genius, a little bit crazy. He's the creator of Family Guy, American Dad, and The Cleveland Show that all air on Sundays on Fox. His movie Ted is available on the DVDs and the Blu-ray December the 11th. Take a look at this. Seth MacFarlane, everybody. Seth MacFarlane. Like a real show, isn't it?
You know, the driver that you guys sent me, we pulled into the gate and he said, yeah, I have Seth MacFarlane, he's here for the Craig Kilborn show.
Great! Yeah. We're getting there! We're on our way!
update these people.
No, I think that's good. That means we're halfway there. You got my first name right. That's cool.
Yeah, I guess, you know what? You're a glasses half full guy. Thank you.
Are you drunk?
Only slightly.
No, because every time you're on the show, you're always like, you get nervous, you get liquored up, and you're like,
I'm not doing it this time because your people said I couldn't.
No, you can get... No, man, I don't want people leaving here thinking I have standards. That's wrong.
I think, you know, this place has turned into Captain Kangaroo.
I don't think anyone... Little bit. I know what you mean.
A lot of old people in the audience, huh?
Yeah, yeah. It's all right. Listen, I love this movie.
Oh, thank you.
It was fantastic. It's the best profane bear movie I've ever seen.
Thank you. And that includes Mrs. Doubtfire, right?
I quite like Mrs. Doubtfire. you know, the scene where Ted whips Mark across the ass with the car area.
Yeah,
spoiler
like that?
Alert. I found that kind of erotic.
Yeah. You know, that's the Scottish for you, I guess. I don't know. You guys are into some crazy, crazy.
Crikey. Not all of us, just a little bit.
I can swear too, right? It's not just you.
I can't swear at all. They beep me.
Do they? Like,
yeah, if I say Lingonberry, never make the word. What? You're gonna host the Oscars. You're the man. I gotta clean up my act. You bet.
By the way, I think it's hilarious that you made a Kardashian joke in the monologue, and that was the line for these guys. I heard they got very offended.
Yeah, they're like, ooh, come on.
They are.
Lay off.
The Kardashians are our royalty.
Yeah, I don't. Maybe yours. I don't know if that's true. You think that's true?
I can find no other explanation for it.
No, I think people are just kind of fascinated by those little people going around with their hairy little bodies.
Yeah. That's it. Look at the mean look that horse has given us.
I think that secretary
you put Bobcat Goldthwait's voice in that. You got to hit it, my friend.
We can't have any more voices in camera. We can't do it. Although I wanted a Ted. Yeah. I know that there was a Ted around. I wanted Ted to sit on top of the rhino and just cuss at me from time to time.
Look at this.
It could work. What's going on, man? What are you doing for Christmas?
I don't know. You know, I haven't figured out my holiday plans yet.
You mean you hate Christmas?
Well, you know.
And also America? Is that what you're saying? So you hate America, is what you're saying.
You know, I think of America as my alcoholic uncle who I love very much.
Oh, that's fair. Hey, what are you going to do for the Oscars, though? I'm concerned for you. Why would you do that gig?
I don't know. I'm now having extreme doubts after talking to you. I think I'm in a lot of trouble. No, it sounded like a lot of fun.
It sounded like a lot of fun, but you're gonna have to do it.
Are you gonna
have a band and stuff?
I don't know. I think we're just gonna kinda go unrehearsed until the night, just kinda wing it and just see what happens. And then just, you know, that's how you do this show, right?
Yeah, but this show is not important.
This show is important to a lot of people, man.
Thanks, man.
Yeah. This show's getting American soldiers through their tour of duty, providing them with laughs.
Okay, knock it off. you now own the Fox Network, then? So you are, in fact, the new Rupert Murdoch. It's you.
Let's not get us. I don't want to wake up tomorrow with a bullet in my head with his initials on it. So, you know, let's not get hysterical here.
He's got your phone tapped. He has to have your phone tapped. He has your phone tapped.
He must.
Yeah,
he must.
He definitely does. He knows when you're sleeping and he knows when you're awake.
He does. He knows when I'm hanging my stockings by the chimney with disdain.
Are you not going to have any Christmas at all?
I'll come up with something. Something always turns up.
Well, you can, you know, family and friends and gather around a tree and roast some chestnuts. Come on, man.
Is that safe, around roasting chestnuts?
No, it's dangerous to roast stuff around a tree, but I'm just trying to, like, right there, look at that tree so close to that fire. That is a fire hazard right there.
That is. That's... If that tree gets anywhere... that tree gets anywhere near that Ansel Adams, you're in trouble.
Yeah, it's... It's a photograph joke.
Is
I think you get the wrong show, buddy.
Yeah.
That's one of your, that's one of them John Stewart jokes right there.
Right.
One of them smart aleck jokes right there.
I'll clean it up.
It's all right. So listen, I loved being on American Dad, and it was so great you asked me back. Oh, wait, you didn't.
Oh, God. Here we go.
What the hell?
They told me you had party favors under your desk. Is that true?
Yeah. I got some. I got a trombone under here, but it's a little rusty.
Do you really?
Yeah. Yeah, there you go. What?
Wow. Let's see. I haven't done this since high school.
That's awesome, man.
Oh, there you go. I like that.
You want to sit in?
Huh?
You want to sit in? Yeah,
here, man,
what is this? No, come on, you can do it.
What am I going to do?
Play yourself
with that,
out,
with this
we're
great
done
band.
Anyway.
We are? All right.
Yeah, play yourself out. My next guest is a very beautiful woman. She's a businesswoman, really. She's an author and a model. She's featured in the Victoria's Secret Fashion Show, which is airing tomorrow night at 10 on CBS. Really? You hear that? Victoria's Secret Fashion Show is on CBS tomorrow.
It's fantastic.
Yeah, you... I'm like... I'm
looking up around here.
I am single.
Huh?
I'm single.
Yeah, you... Miranda Kerr, everybody, Miranda Kerr. You look absolutely... Welcome, Miranda. You look absolutely lovely. Like, really very nice indeed. I don't know
Thank
if anyone's
you.
Ever told you before, but you're reasonably attractive young lady.
Thank you. And you're very handsome, too.
Yeah, you got to throw a bit more oomph behind it if you're going to say it.
You're a very handsome man.
A little bit more.
I think that we should take our kids on a play date together.
Yeah, that's safe. What age are your kids?
I have a son.
Right.
And he's around the same age as your son.
Well, my youngest boy is 2, and then I have another one who's... You can't have an 11-year-old.
No,
that'd be,
I don't.
You know,
no.
That's impossible.
Mine's going to be 2 in January.
Well, yeah, mine's going to be 2 in January, too.
Yeah.
Let's get them together and get them in a band.
Yeah. Oh, my son can play the piano.
My son can play the piano better than your son.
I'm not sure about that.
Maybe we should set them in a sort of piano-playing race.
Well...
How could he play the piano at 2?
Okay, well, he can't really play the piano, but he walked into this... We did a play date thing, and he walked into the room. The first thing he made a beeline for was the piano. And he got up there and just... It was a little mini piano, a kid's one.
Right.
And he got up there and just started playing. And I was like, wow.
That's what Richie did. That's the same story.
It does run in my family. It does run in my family, though.
Yeah, that's fantastic.
It's in our blood.
Do you play the piano?
I do, a little.
A little piano, or you play the piano a little bit?
A little piano.
Right. You play a tiny... That's adorable.
Yeah, my grandma is amazing.
And mine too, but she doesn't play the piano. Well, you come on here saying your kid's better than my kid, your grandma's better than my grandma. Who the hell do you think you are, lady?
I come from down under.
Australia?
Yeah. Aussie. Oi, 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 yeah.
You know that Kerr is a Scottish name, though?
It is.
Oh, it is?
Yes.
Well, there you are, then.
I have Scottish and Irish in my ancestry.
That must... Are you fond of whiskey?
No, but I like Guinness.
Well, Guinness is good.
Yeah.
I mean, if you like that sort of thing, I don't know. I don't know if I can say that on TV, but I used to enjoy Guinness immensely before I stopped.
Yes. And now, what is your preferred drink?
Tea.
Tea. What kind of tea?
Oh, I like an Earl Grey, really. Or
I like an Earl Grey too.
Do you really?
Yeah, I love
Earl Grey. Oh, I think we'll get along nice, actually.
Yeah. Yeah. Earl Grey.
Earl Grey or a bit of Darjeeling, maybe. I like a bit of Darjeeling.
No.
What the hell? You think your grandma's better than my grandma?
Let's just have a play date and then we can drink some tea. And...
Wait, I'm one of your girlfriends now, haven't I? When did I become this non-threatening? That's awful, but great at the same time. No, I think it's lovely. Well,
it's so
you're. Yeah, your baby's American then.
Yeah, he was born here in LA. Mm-hmm.
Mine too?
Yeah.
Wait.
And my husband's English.
Okay.
So my son has got, you know.
He's English, Australian, and American.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, he's going to do well. Do you. So in the fashion show tomorrow night, are you walking up and down with your underwear on?
I am. And I have some wings on as well.
Yeah, I think I've seen one of those things. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's quite a look.
It's something different. You don't see it every day.
Do you get embarrassed walking around like that, kind of, you know?
To be honest, I don't get embarrassed, but what I do find is that if I have friends or my husband in the audience watching, I get, oh my goodness, that's a little embarrassing. Because it's almost like you put...
Your husband presumably has seen you in your underwear before.
He has. But it's different because I'm parading it in front of everyone else, not just him, you know?
So, like at home, do you walk up and down in your underwear for your husband? Because that makes you the most awesome
sometimes.
Wife in America.
Yeah, I do.
Yeah. That's nice.
You know, let's bring it back to my grandma, okay?
Here we go, you and your grandma.
What she said to me about, she said about men. Men are very visual, so don't forget that. She said, every day, just put a little makeup on, put on some nice underwear, and you'll keep your husband. That's what she told me.
You know, I think there's truth in that.
Yeah.
And when I say that, I mean for me. I can't speak for all men, but I think men are visual. Aren't women visual too, though?
No, women need to be mentally stimulated.
I see. Would you like...
I also like your horse.
You like my horse?
Do you... I grew up with horses.
In a stable?
We didn't actually have a stable. He was in the paddock.
Oh, I thought you were, like, raised by horses.
No, I grew up riding horses.
Oh, that's a great thing. Are you going to teach your kid to ride horses?
Yeah.
But when he's finished with the piano?
Once he's done with the piano, I think I might teach him to ride a horse.
Yeah, I think it's...
I like it.
Yeah, me too. And
I had a lot of fun on the back of a horse.
What are we talking about? Yeah, listen, you're blushing. You walk up and down with your underwear, but this is what makes you blush? All right, we're out of time. You want a piece of fruit?
Oh, yeah, okay. I'll take the apple.
Really? There's some coconuts here.
Oh, I love coconut.
I like coconut too. Would you like me to smash it for you?
No. Do you know your blood type?
Yes.
What is it?
I think it's O.
Well, you should have a banana, because bananas are good for your blood type. Just saying. Just putting it out there.
So, let me get this straight. Your kid's better than my kid. Your grandma's better than my grandma. And I should have a banana.
Yeah.
Well, what's your blood type?
I'm an A.
So...
I'm an A positive.
Yes, you are. So, what kind of fruit should you have then?
Apple.
Well, then have an apple then. It's a little tiny apple.
It's a little.
See, it'll look nice on your little piano.
Yeah. It smells good.
It's an apple. Miranda Kerr, everybody, Miranda.
Los Angeles area and would like to attend a taping of the Late Late Show with Craig Ferguson, please call 323-570-0059 or visit llstickets.com.
Welcome back, everybody. Welcome back. My next guest, and here all week, is a gigantic rock star. He's sold more than 130 million albums worldwide. He's still agreed to be the house band here. Here performing Every Road Leads Home to You from the album Aftermath of the Lowdown. Please welcome my friend, Richie Sambora, everybody. Richie Richie Sambora, everybody. See you tomorrow. Good night.
See you tomorrow.